Okay, so I'm going to be doing an eyeliner look. So first I'd like to use a prong eyeliner. This is a really cheap one that I can find in a drugstore. Just any cheap ones that you can find will do. What I do is I will do my waterline here. So it looks like this. I start with a brown gloss and I want to see the definition that it brings, and I will check because this is I'm just doing this look for like if I want to do a very heavy lip because fall is already here and we should wear dark colors. So I'm just doing an eye look. I'm showing y'all how I usually do my eye look if I want to go very heavy with the lip. So next I'm going in with the LA Colors Auto Eyeliner. It's in light brown. And then after that I'll check to see if that's enough for me. And then I will go, and then if not, then I'll go in with a black again. Okay, so this is enough of a definition for me, so I'm going to do both sides. Now I'm going to be doing my eyeliner, because as you can see, my eyes are two different shapes, so I have to bring out a super thin line, a semi-thin line, but make sure that it matches on both sides. So it depends on how high a flick you want to do. I usually don't go for that high of a flick because it gives me problems. Because as you can see, I'm monolithic here, and doing a super thin cat eye can be a bit of a feat on its own. So I'm just marking it out. Bring it up to my pupil here, because what's also different about my eye, more than just being two different lid shapes, is that one is quite round, which is this side, and one is quite long and flat. So I need to sort of elongate this but not add to the width of it. So this is one eye, then I'll be doing the next. I need to take a... Okay, I'm just using this to solve, because it's getting a bit out of shape. I'm just going to use this to carve it out a bit, and then sort of wipe off the remainder. So this is one shape on the eye, and then I'm going to do the other. So as you can see, because my lid folds over the liner, I need to draw a bit extra here to round it up. So then when I open up, it comes out like this. And then I fill it in. Usually I ignore this, which is I draw in, because it just becomes too much of a hassle sometimes for me. But for today's sake, I'm gonna do it. This side is a bit of a hassle for me because as you can see, my lid is completely exposed here, so how much eyeliner I put here will affect how it looks overall, because you can see very clearly. There's like no mistakes about. And I need to re-carve the upside here again using the same brush as just now. I drew too far out here, so I need to add extra. As you can probably tell, for me, my eyeliner just got a bit too overzealous. But if you can do a super thin liner, then you just go for it. This is just my own version of a liner because I have different shaped eyes, so me without makeup is not that obvious, but the moment I start putting on makeup, it becomes very apparent. So it looks like this. This is probably the most correct, and then I would usually go into my waterline and add, because I find that if I don't, it looks a bit too heavy. So I'm using a light brown one, which I used initially, and I'm just going in. I've already done my base because for me, I think there's no point in me doing base. Most people don't really need to do it as much as I do. So if I have time, I will film another one for y'all. And after that, I just apply mascara and then we are finished. Alright, so I've done my under eye. Going to wear mascara, and then after that, I'm going to do a bit of my brows because I usually don't leave it as it is because I find that it's a bit, I mean, it's really well shaped, but it's not as good as I would like it. So I'm using this thing which is called the Too Cool for School. I don't know what. I got this in China. I think they discontinued it completely, so you can't really find it. But just do your usual brow, which is, yeah. Basically like mixing the two shades, black and brown, together. Because I have both black and brown hair right now, because of like a lot of sun. So this is powder on. Then what I will do is I will take a brush. So basically just get a spoolie. I don't have a tool that has a spoolie, so I usually use those with two ends, and then I just brush through. Because if you put on powder, right, the problem with powder is very fast, but it can look very unnatural because it's just like, it feels like a block. So what you always have to do after that is this. And then done. Now I'll go on to blush. Because I'll be going for a very heavy lid, what I usually do is I go for a very soft application of blush, because I don't want it to look like, when you're doing a heavy lip look, you want it to be on the lip, but you also want to look like you're a vampire because you have no color on your cheeks. So what the blush does is it makes you look human, but it shouldn't like overpower the heavy lip that you're doing. So so if the light seems like it's changing, because I think it's gonna rain outside, and I'm using as much natural light as I can to do it. Maybe I should turn on. Never mind. So this is the blush, and then I'll be showing you all the different looks that I have. So.